Hello everyone and welcome. I'm Marietta and today I would like to introduce you to our new research project called Music, Movement, Mood and Parkinson's. It is an international collaboration between the University of Hertfordshire and the Lucerne University of Applied Sciences and Arts in Switzerland. We've got funding from the Swiss National Science Foundation as well as Parkinson's Schweiz, which is the Swiss version of Parkinson's UK. The main goal of our research project is to develop and test a new group-based music and movement course to improve quality of life for with people with Parkinson's, practitioners, medical professionals, and researchers. We are using a patient and public involvement approach for our research because we want to put people with Parkinson's and their needs first. Rather than prescribing a new treatment, we are treating people with Parkinson's as the experts that they are and include them throughout the entire research process. So their expertise has been crucial for the development of a new course. To start with, I would like to introduce the whole team to you. Dr. Dawn Rose is the principal investigator and the one person that made this project up based on her previous research. One of you might know her from her work for the dance classes for Parkinson's at the University of Hertfordshire, or the motion capture drum circle, or maybe the tapping studies she did. Our postdoctoral research fellow is Dr. Sabrina Köchli. She is in charge of the Swiss laboratory, which includes all motion capture and pressure sensitive gait med equipment that we are using to measure the effects of our new course. Then there is me. I'm a PhD student at the University of Hertfordshire and focuses on the patient and public involvement as well as helping running the new course. Maria Thomas is a facilitator and arts manager and has over 20 years experience of education and managing events and other artistic projects. We are very happy to have her facilitating our new course. And of course, there's Penny Harrington. She's another PhD student at the University of Hertfordshire and helping to run the new course. I would like to talk a bit more about me personally. So, and because it's all about music, I thought, why not introduce myself via favorite music? So I will play this tune and then I will say a couple of words. I love this music and could listen to it forever. When I was a child, Indiana Jones had been an idol to me. I wanted to become an explorer and adventurer just like him, so listening to this music keeps me motivated and energizes me. Also, I'm a huge fan of film music and used to do studies about the emotional and physiological effects of film music during my bachelor's degree. Maybe you at home would also like to think of a song that you identify yourself with. So after my bachelor's degree, I started my master's course in systematic musicology, which is a fancy word for music psychology. So during that, I focused mainly on music psychology and different research methods, so statistics or qualitative methods. After I finished that, I started working at the School of Music at the Lucerne University of Applied Sciences and Arts in Switzerland. And since September 2022, I'm an enrolled PhD student at the University of Hertfordshire, and in my thesis, I focus on the motivational effects of music for people with Parkinson's. I would like to talk a bit more about the collaborators of our project. So in the UK, we are partnered with the University of Hertfordshire, as I said, and our colleagues there are Dr. Caroline Wyatt, who is a motion capture specialist, and Dr. Lucy Annett, who is a Parkinson's research specialist. Both of them are also my PhD supervisors. Our Swiss collaborators comprise of Professor Dr. Stefan Bollhalter, who is the head of neurology, and Dr. Tim van Belling, who's the head of neurological rehabilitation at the Lucerne Regional Hospital. In the southern parts of Switzerland, known as Ticino, we are partnered with Professor Dr. Salvatore Galati, head of neurology at the Lugano Regional Hospital, and Dr. Daria Dinat, she's the head of neuro rehab at the Lugano Regional Hospital, as well as at the Clinic Hildebrand. These collaborations really make this transdisciplinary work possible, and we are grateful to everyone for the time, care, and thoughtfulness in our working practice together. The project is divided into four parts across 4 years. We have completed the consultation stage and the developmental stage, and we now have ethical clearance for the UK trial this year, and we are working on Swiss ethics and the methods of data capture. During the consultation, we did 5 workshops with people with Parkinson's, practitioners, medical professionals, and researchers in the UK. And after that, we repeated them in the German and Italian-speaking areas of Switzerland. Each of the 5 workshops was themed and lasted for about an hour. We started with music, mood, and identity, considering concepts such as music and autobiographical memories, and the effects of diagnosis on identity. Then we considered different ways of engaging with music, including the effects we get from listening alone and together, as well as the potential for making music. During the 3rd workshop, we looked into ways of listening and ways of imagining music to help cue movements. The 4th workshop was about trying out some percussion instruments and understanding the 4 components of rhythm: repetition, tempo, synchronization, and syncopation. The 5th workshop was a feedback session for the ideas we had had for the content of the course. There are 2 important lessons we learned from the workshops that I would like to share with you in relation to active rhythmic engagement. Firstly, the importance of mirroring movements. Here you can see a person with Parkinson's playing the sword drum first alone. As you can see, it was difficult to control the movements, but once the person was copying someone else, in this case Dawn, it became much easier to control the movements. The 2nd lesson we learned is about vocables. We learned that it is even easier for people to copy rhythms if they say words out loud whilst copying. So we can try this with some body drumming, and you can join me at home if you like. Now, if you would just say the words, it's hard to know the rhythm: storm, storm, clap, clap, storm. But if I show you, then it's easier, and you can copy me. So it goes like this: stomp, stomp, clap, clap, stomp, stomp, clap, stomp, stomp, knee, 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 stomp, stomp, clap. If you join me and speak the words whilst copying me, you will find staying in tune much easier. So now let's talk about the new course we created based on all 15 of the previous workshops: songlines. Our aim with this course is basically to help people with Parkinson's move and to help feel them better. Of course, we also have to write this in scientific language, which, as you can see on the slide, normally involves a lot more words. So the basics first. The course will last for 12 weeks. The number of weeks is based on other successful courses and allows for the occasional missed week. Though we don't encourage that, we are realists and we appreciate it is a long time to commit to. So the first course, the first group, will start at the 22nd of May and goes till the 14th of August. The second group would start on the 11th of September and goes till the 4th of December. We have found a venue to do this course, and it's the Hampson Park Community Centre in Stevenage. So the course will be in the same place at the same time each week. Parking at Hampson Park is easy, but there are other transport options available, and we have funding to cover all your travel costs. We can arrange taxis or lifts if needed. Each session will last for 70 minutes. The slot we have starts at 11:30, so the sessions will run until 12:40. As there is an on-site cafe, we can cater for a light lunch after the session. This hopefully allows for some time to socialize, but doesn't eat into your day too much. And finally, there will be weekly homework. But don't panic yet. In addition to collecting quantitative data, which is what is needed to provide what's called an evidence base to demonstrate whether something works or not, I will be collecting qualitative data. This is less about numbers and more about your experience. It is very important to gather your feedback on what worked and didn't work in each class so we can improve it, how your week was, and whether you were able to use any of the strategies or techniques at home. All participants will be given a booklet that explains the content of each week and with space to make notes if wanted. We will also provide you with a CD or downloadable playlist for your phone of the music we will use in the sessions, and this will be added to as we collect music you have discovered in your weekly homework. So, for clarification, weekly homework means searching for pieces of music that might be helpful in particular situations, but there is no pressure, and if you don't stumble across a song, that is completely fine and something we can talk about during the phone calls. So, every session of the Songlines course involves different sections, which you can see here. To start with, we have a warm-up to arrive in the setting. Then we do some guided body drumming and percussion, known as active rhythmic engagement. Then we have a first educational rest period in which we will talk about music. The hive mind section will be a group problem solving of everyday problems. The next section will be me doing a mini lecture about rhythms from around the world. This is our second educational resting period. After that, we will do some moving to music from around the world to discover different styles of movements. The cool down contains qigong sequences to recover calm and relax. I will go through of some of the sections to bring it all a bit more to life and provide some examples. Let's talk, for example, about the weather warm-up. Both British and Swiss people seemed fascinated with the weather, partly because it changes so often in both countries. The idea here is that we start seated in a circle, gently warming up our voices and bodies, trying to copy sounds guided by the course facilitator and copying body movements, maybe trying some body drumming, and eventually standing and moving towards a table in the center of the circle, on which there will be a variety of instruments. Being together in a circle is an important part of ritual and allows us to see each other as equals. We may also play some instruments by the chairs for this exercise. For example, rain sticks are a lovely gentle sound that might get drowned out a bit as the storm scene builds. You can see here some of the other instruments we thought to include in this section. The first rest period allows me to explain the thinking behind the name of the course. Songlines is the name given to ancient indigenous or aboriginal art of navigating time and space in Australia. To remember the way from one place to another, they would create songs with meaningful lyrics that would guide them across the terrain, but also keep them happy whilst they were traveling. Once they reached their destination, they were able to hold the message stick, which meant they had the right to talk and be heard. As much of our work is about how music can help guide our mood and movement, we thought this story brought our aims alive. The most important part of this section, though, is the chance to share music that is meaningful to the group. So, before you start the course, I will ask you to name a few songs that mean a lot to you. And then once a week, we will play a song and have a chance to talk about why it matters and what it brings. We think that this will help the groups bond, and we won't force anyone to share something they don't want to. The facilitators, which means Maria, Penny, and me, will also share songs that matter to us. The music and movement section is divided into two parts. Part one includes six different themes: marching music, African and Latin music, European folk music, Eastern music, such as Bollywood, and Western art music, such as Baroque dancing. Additionally, the second part of the music and movement section is to develop a line dancing sequence over the entire 12-week period. The sequence will involve specific movements to help with improving functional mobility, but in a fun way. So, for example, swapping cowboy hats involves reaching and coordination. Although the course lasts for 12 weeks, we are asking people who are interested in taking part in this first trial to commit to about 20 weeks in total. This is because we have to take a series of measurements in order to know if the course is helping. Each measurement session lasts for about 2 hours, and we will cover any travel costs and provide refreshments. The best plan we have come up with that is scientifically sound yet doable is called a within-subject repeated measures trial. This means that you can act as your own comparison. We think this is best because everyone's Parkinson's is different. But that means we have to measure 2 times before the course starts, once about a month before, and once as close to the start date as possible. Then we measure once afterwards straight away, and about a month later, I will do follow-up phone calls to check whether or not the people still use the strategies learned and how they feel. The trial starts in the UK, and we propose to run 2 groups of 12 to 15 people, with the first group starting in April and the second group starting in August. To measure differences in the functional mobility, we combine the two technologies known as pressure-sensitive gait mat and motion capture. The measurements include 3 tasks: walking, the timed up and go, that's a standardized test to measure functional mobility, and a new measurement that we specifically developed for people with Parkinson's, the functional mobility assessment in Parkinson's. It contains of different movements, and here you can watch me perform it. We included a door frame because some people with Parkinson's tend to freeze before them, and we hope that the musical strategies learned during song lines will help to overcome freezing by internalizing musical cues that help movement. Here are 2 videos that show you how the motion capture system looks. So on the left side, you can see the raw data of a person with Parkinson's. And on the right side, you can see the labeled version. This will help us, for example, to see differences in the posture. If you would like to have further information or want to get in touch with us, we've got the project website and also our own research blog. But please feel free to always contact Dawn Rose, the project leader, or me. I'm very happy to answer any queries. Thank you very much for listening to me. I hope you enjoyed it, and I'm looking forward to hearing from you. Have a nice day. Goodbye.